I've been a little bit obsessed with a lot of different historical eras lately, including some fairly ancient ones, and my research interests have been kind of just all over the place. I feel like I was pulled out of Plato's cave after a while of only making and wearing 1700s and 1800s clothing, and now suddenly, outside of the cave, I've realized how many exciting things there are to be discovered. I mean, I already knew there were many periods of fashion history that are fascinating, but a couple of years ago, the idea of truly exploring them felt overwhelming. And that's definitely not the case anymore. I kept seeing a style of historical shoe around this past 6 months or so, and then one day I was speaking with my friend Devon, who happens to make absolutely incredible historical garments. I've placed the link to her shop in the description box because all of the clothing she makes is just truly stunning. We somehow got to the subject of discussing the style of historical shoe that I kept seeing around, and suddenly she showed me a pair of Iron Age ones that she made. This conversation inspired me to make my own, and so I got to researching a little bit. Now, although I've made plenty of historical clothing, I have never made shoes before, nor worked with leather, so I felt this might perhaps be an easy way to dip my toes into leather work and making at least simple footwear. Thankfully, the Leather Conservation Center has a lovely and brief article about Iron Age footwear, as well as another article which has beautiful instructions about how to make your own pair. Depending upon the region of the world, the dates for the Iron Age vary. In Western and Central Europe, which is the area where I live, for instance, the time frame is said to be around 800 BCE until the 1st century BCE, although some have said it began as early as the late 11th century BCE. It is typically defined as starting around the beginning of large-scale global iron production, hence the name. I thought it'd be fun to follow the instructions from the Leather Conservation Center and make my own pair of Iron Age shoes, and then try them out on a hike to see how they hold up and if they're even comfortable. Since this is going to be my first attempt, I think that there will be quite a few more experiments in the future needed, but I figured this might be a nice place to start to see what this experimental archaeological adventure might have in store. Let's get to making some shoes. So to make my Iron Age shoes, I began by taking this secondhand leather jacket that I bought from a thrift store for only 10 euros, and I basically performed garment surgery and took the pieces apart. The seam ripper really came in handy here. Most of the pieces on this jacket aren't particularly big, and I hadn't drawn the pattern for the shoes yet, so I had to carefully think about which sections I wanted to use for the shoes. I ultimately decided that these sleeves would probably be most suitable, and at this point I was praying to all of the gods that my pattern would fit. I drew my pattern by tracing my foot onto a piece of cardstock paper, you know, the kind that you find in those big sketchbooks, and then about a 2-finger width distance from the outline, I created a design following the instructions provided in the Leather Conservation Center article. Basically, I freehand drew a sort of Y-shaped back section with 2 tabs, and then a bunch of tabs surrounding the rest of the foot. It looked like an absolute mess, and I am very mediocre at drawing, but I had a feeling it was all going to be okay, and I just trusted the process. After I cut out the pattern, it was the moment of truth, and I had to see if my pattern would fit on the leather.
Let's try and make it work. Gotta get some seam ripper. Just don't want to put the seam allowance.
Once I took the 2 sleeve pieces apart and harvested the largest one, I ended up with a little extra room from the seam allowance, which is just what I needed. Truly, I was at the very edge of the leather.
Wow, so close to the edge. Okay.
I traced the pattern onto the wrong side of the leather with a marker and began cutting. This leather is somewhat thin, as it's jacket leather, which is a detail I'll talk more about later on, so I was able to cut it with fabric scissors, but a lot of people make these shoes with a thicker leather, so an X-Acto knife or, you know, a very sharp stone might be a preferable tool. After the piece was cut, I made some symmetrical holes at the heel with an awl, then I made a hole at each of the tabs and took some leather cord and first strung it through the back to begin forming the shoe, and strung a second piece of leather cord through the remaining ones, which can be gathered up to create a form around the foot. It was a beautiful moment to see the shoe come together, and in the end, I was feeling very excited to actually try wearing it. And, of course, I remembered to make a second one, thankfully. Okay, so now my Iron Age shoes are complete, and tomorrow I'm going to test them out on a little hike to see how they fare. Making these shoes got me curious about some more subtle aspects about shoemaking in general. For instance, were shoes always made for left and right feet? When I tried finding information, it was a mess of contradictions. Some resources claim the Romans were the first people who created shoes designed for left and right feet. However, I also found other sources claiming that you don't see left and right foot lasts being used until the 1800s, and before that, straight lasts without a difference between the left and right foot were used instead. Considering the ancient Roman people wore a lot of sandals, I think it would be quite likely that they'd be designed for both a left and right foot. Not to mention, during ancient times, even like with these Iron Age shoes for instance, the shoe pattern would be cut out and shaped to a wearer's foot, which technically means a left and right shoe. And then there's also evidence of ancient Egyptian sandals that clearly show a distinct left and right foot. So it seems to me that it's unlikely the differentiated left and right foot shoes only became a thing in the 1800s. So yeah, just something I got curious about and wanted to share my findings with you all. Since this is my first time making these shoes, or any shoes for that matter, this is definitely an experiment, and I often like to approach experimental archaeology in parts, trying the same experiment more than once. For this first attempt, my main goal was to create a wearable pattern in shoe, which I would say was a great success. Regarding things I think I probably want to try for the next pair I make, I'd like to use a thicker leather because I'm uncertain about the durability of this thinner jacket leather, but I guess we're going to find out soon enough. Also, I'd like to try using a finer leather cord, as this one is quite bulky and I'm worried it might get uncomfortable, but I guess we're also going to find out. And at some point in the future, I'd like to try making a pair of these using only Iron Age tools, so perhaps creating the pattern directly onto the leather and just using my foot as a guide, and then cutting the pieces out with a sharp rock. But that's an experiment for another time. I think we've already done enough for this one. For now, I'm going to get some sleep, and tomorrow we can see how well this version holds up. All right, good night. See you all then. And so I headed out to the nature wearing my newly made Iron Age shoes. Before leaving home, I had to think about what type of stockings I'd wear. Most likely during the Iron Age, a fabric wrapped around the legs and then held up by garters may have been worn, or perhaps stockings that were made with a technique called knoll binding, which is also sometimes called needle binding. This technique is older than both crochet and knitting. Since I don't have either of those options, I decided to go with the next best thing, a pair of historical replica wool knitted stockings. So I have my Iron Age shoes on now, and I've been walking around with them a little bit in this green space. So far I'd say that they're fairly comfortable, but it does definitely feel like I'm essentially walking around barefoot. Since the leather is so thin, it offers very little actual protection for my feet, but I'm pretty used to wearing thin-soled shoes, so I actually really prefer barefoot wear. And historical shoes in general, I find they tend to be much thinner on the soles, especially the further back you go. So this isn't really all that new to me. But I would say overall, it's not bad, especially considering how thin the leather is. It could be a lot worse. I'm really curious to see what this will be like with thicker soles. Also, I thought that the thicker leather cord was going to be irritating for my feet, but I actually don't notice it at all. So that's a good thing. And I'm sure as well too, once I wore them more, they would sort of mold and wear into my feet. So then they'd probably become even more comfortable. All right, well, I'm gonna keep walking around, and I will see you all back at home. I just got home, and I would say it was a great success. These are my Iron Age shoes in all of their glory, and I would say the only thing is that my feet got a little bit cold. I'm glad that I was wearing stockings because that at least helped to keep them a bit warmer, but basically the leather didn't get soaked through, so my feet didn't actually become damp, but I sort of felt the coldness of the damp creeping through into my feet. So I think a solution to this would be to coat them in beeswax or lanolin, and when I make another pair with thicker leather, I will definitely be doing this and then also returning to coat these ones as well because I think it'll just help to add a little water-resistant layer. I do not think that these are shoes designed for wet, cold seasons, but it is autumn and I did feel pretty okay wearing them, and I think if I'd coated them it would have been perfectly fine, so maybe just not a winter shoe or not a shoe to wear in very heavy rain. But yeah, this was such a fun experiment, and I highly, highly encourage you that if you would like to make your own Iron Age shoes, follow the instructions that I include in the description box. It's super easy to make these, and you end up with a really beautiful result, if I might say so myself. And I think this would be a really fun activity as well to help your children learn about experimental archaeology if they're interested in history. I think as well this more interactive approach will teach them a lot about what it may have actually been like for people at that time. If you'd like to see me wear only ancient Greek fashion for an entire 30 days, then be sure to watch this video next. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.